Hello, this is David Briggs speaking to you on Saturday the 25th of July from New York City. A very warm and humid day here, also incredibly quiet. Wow, all the people. Those people who are venturing out, it's great to see that pretty much everybody is wearing their masks and being respectful, which is just great. Meanwhile, I hope you are staying safe and well and away from this horrible virus. I guess, like me, you're very, very grateful for this wonderful news that's come out of Oxford and this week about the vaccine, and let's all really hope and pray for the best about the swift evolution of this vaccine, so that we can get back to something more like normal. Well, one of the things I'm most grateful for during this period is regular access to my home base, the Cathedral of St. John the Divine, and I go in every Tuesday and every Thursday for about 5 hours each. It's also incredibly humid in the cathedral. The building is so huge that there's no air conditioning, and I think a couple of days ago it was 88 degrees Fahrenheit and very humid. So we do have these big industrial fans, which they play on a slightly flat A flat, so it's not great if you're playing music in any other key. Well, today, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to propose to you this very beautiful piece by Sir Edward Elgar from the Gem of Gerontius. For 12 years earlier in my career in a former incarnation, I had the great honor of being very closely associated with the Three Choirs Festival. First of all, as assistant organist at Hereford in the late 80s, and then for 8.5 years as organist of Gloucester Cathedral. You can see here the wonderful Gloucester organ, which I still miss. It's an absolutely fabulous instrument, of course. And one of the great things about being so closely involved in the Three Choirs was gaining a very intimate and inside knowledge of this great corpus of Elgar oratorios, this triumvirate of fabulous pieces, the Gem of Gerontius, the Kingdom, and the Apostles. And I had the great fortune to be the repetitor for a couple of performances of the Gerontius when I was at Hereford, and then conducted it at Gloucester. And this was really one of the greatest experiences I think I've ever had. An absolutely fabulous piece dating from 1900, Sir Edward Elgar. And I remember one rehearsal in Hereford in, I think it was probably 1987, when my good friend Roy Massey was conducting the rehearsal. I was playing the piano. And in the interval, a little old lady from the back of the second altos came up to Roy and said, "Oh, Dr. Massey, I thought you might like to know that Sir Edward used to do it this way." She was talking about the famous Demons chorus. This was a lady, I suppose, perhaps she was in her late 70s, and she'd sung in 1933 under Elgar at the Three Choirs Festival, and remembered it and recounted the sort of sound that Edward Elgar wanted during the Demons chorus. Well, this arrangement that I'm going to perform for you at St. John the Divine today was made by the organist of Gloucester Cathedral at the beginning of the 20th century, Sir Herbert Brewer. Amazingly, for the whole century, there were only four organists. Herbert Brewer started his time there in 1896 till his death in 1928. He was a very good friend of Elgar. And then Herbert Sumption was appointed in 27-28 and remained in office for an extraordinary tenure until 1967, when my immediate predecessor, John Sanders, came back to Gloucester. He'd previously been the assistant, and John remained until my appointment, which was in June 1994. So Brewer made this arrangement of two parts of the Gem of Gerontius. In fact, the very opening of the piece, the prelude, and then the angel's farewell, which is, well, as you'll hear, it's an absolutely hauntingly beautiful piece of music. And in fact, 41 years ago this morning, my dad, John Briggs, passed on into eternity. He had a major cardiac event at home, aged just 55, and I still think about him most days, and he informs a lot of my decision making, and I'm always thinking of him and what he would say. And I'd like to dedicate this performance to his memory, especially that he's being well nurtured and taken care of by all these angels, which Elgar portrays in this fabulous piece of music. I hope you enjoy it.